says, the Lord is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Yeah. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Everybody just say so tonight. Say, Lord, you're good. Yeah. And your mercy is what? Endureth forever. Oh, hallelujah. How many can say his mercy endureth forever? Say it again, his mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. His mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed. How many can say, I'm the redeemed? Come on, somebody. Amen. Say it like you mean it. I am the redeemed. Amen. How many are redeemed? If you really need to stand on your feet and say, I am the redeemed of the Lord. The Bible says, let the redeemed. Special songs, but we're so glad to have him back in our city tonight. Amen. Every time he comes, amen, we are blessed. Amen. We just bless you. We just praise God. I can remember, still remember how God blessed and how God saved, how God healed, and all of the wonderful works that were done. In the name of Jesus, amen. God was glorified the last time, and I believe that he's going to be glorified even more. Hallelujah. Hey, how many believe that God is going to take us higher? Take us to a higher level, higher heights and deeper depths. We're so privileged tonight to have a man of this caliber in our midst that has traveled all over the nation and ministering to people, amen, for just about every condition and every challenge and problem that people have. Amen. God raised him up. Over 20 years ago, right now. Amen. Hallelujah. And these have been a blessing to multitudes and multitudes of people. Amen. Nationwide and worldwide. We're just so happy tonight to have him in our midst. And we want everybody to stand on your feet tonight. Let's welcome the man of God all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. Amen. Hallelujah. Evangelist. Pastor. Let's receive it by saying, praise the Lord. I want to say it again, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Let's just lift our hands up and give Jesus the praise. Oh, Father, we thank you tonight. We're so grateful for your love, your peace and joy. We're so thankful for the Holy Spirit. And Lord, we thank you for having your way tonight. And just move, Father, as you please. And we give the word of the Lord to have free course. And Spirit of the living God to have liberty. Not my will, Father, but your will be done, Lord. We give you all the praise and honor and glory in advance. Lord, let us have listening ears. Let our hearts be receptive. Let us not become stale to your word. Let it be fresh in our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, go ahead and shake hands with two people again. Tell them you love them. You're glad they're here. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Y'all go ahead and be seated. Amen. Go ahead and open your Bibles up to, amen, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23. And I've been teaching on this, and y'all need to hear this and allow this to sharpen you up. Amen. And I thank God for Pastor Hill and Sister Marilyn. I love you all so much. And the saints here, all of you that came, amen, praise God. I'm going to preach to you all like it's 50,000 in here.
Ooh, right. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hebrews 10:23, and listen carefully to this, because if you're not careful, you can allow things to slip. I know y'all been taught this here, but I'm telling you, the word of God need to stay on our hearts. We need to keep people in remembrance of the word, don't we? You know, you can't live in what you did yesterday. You got to live in what you believe and speak today.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We pull Amen. Off of the inspiration of yesterday. We remember so our faith can keep working. Amen. What Christ did for us. Amen. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful and promised.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at this verse right here, there's a word in here, italicized, that messed this whole verse up, and it needs to be taken out. Mm-hmm. And it's called our. All right. So look in your Bible and see if the word our is a little different letters than the rest of them. That means they added this in there. It's not in the original Greek. All right. And so sometimes they add in words that help a verse. This one hurts it. It really hurts it. And the reason why is it makes you focus on your faith. And that's not really what the Lord wants us to do. That's why people fail so much and people struggle in the faith message. It's that they're focused on them, trying to believe God. Mm-hmm. And boy, they be trying to believe God. Yeah. Man, we believe with all, we doing the best we can, and really, God really don't want us to do our best. And really, just to be honest with you, he really don't want us to try our hardest. And this will mess some of y'all up that ain't never heard me before. God really don't want you living right in your strength.
Right.
And so, in Jesus is where God wants you to live.
Yeah.
Now, Jesus lived a perfect life. Oh! Did he?
Yeah.
Did he live with no sin?
Yes.
That's the life God done called you to live.
Amen.
And you're going to have to do it by faith.
Yes.
You're not going to do it yourself. Right. And so let me read this correctly. Let us hope that the word profession there in the Greek means confession. That means something you're going to be saying out of your mouth. Let us hold fast the confession of faith. Of faith. Now look at without wavering. For he, Jesus, is faithful that promised. So here we see that he wants us to hold fast to the confession of faith. Now, what in the world is faith? Well, faith, you all, is Jesus Christ. Who Jesus is, what Jesus did, that's faith. And a lot of times, we done been taught to try to believe God that he'll supply needs, but we miss at the end, they're in Christ Jesus. So holding fast to who Jesus is and what Jesus did will get all your needs met. Amen. And so a lot of times, people done left Jesus out of faith. And Jesus is faith. Jesus said out his own mouth, In John 6:63, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life.
Mm-hmm. Yes, amen.
Jesus, everything he said happened. And so he's faith. So let us, the only way we're going to get Jesus to work for us perfectly, and I ain't learned how to do all of that, but what I have learned work every day. Because I hadn't had a depressed day in 23 and a half years, but I sure have had some marvelous opportunities. I hadn't been late on bills or paid interest on credit cards in my whole Christian walk, ministry, church, or personal. And boy, have I paid some things on the last day. But I've always seen the Lord come through. I kept him on my lips. See, real Bible faith is hearing.
All right.
It's hearing what Jesus said. Let's look at that. And I want to show you something before we turn. Let us hold fast the confession of faith of faith of who Jesus is, what Jesus did, without wavering. For he is faithful that promised. Now, what is his promise? You got to know what his promise is. It's his own words. So anytime you go through anything in life, all you need is a word from Jesus. And faith is that. You just need either Jesus to speak to you from his written word or to speak to you in your spirit. But every time that you need God to come through for you, you need a word from Jesus to bring you faith. Amen. You need Jesus to tell you what to do.
Yeah. Yeah.
You need Jesus to tell you what to believe.
Yeah. Yeah.
All he had to do is say, oh, I'm going to make this happen. Now you have faith. Trust me for this. Now you have faith. Now, how do we operate in his faith? We got to hear what he say. We got to believe it in our heart and then say it with our mouth and then act upon the word. This is the only way it's going to work. Now, there's sometimes when you walk by faith where all you do is speak. You don't get to do nothing else. You know, to be righteous. To receive the gift of righteousness, you just believe I'm righteous. But then it takes action for you to do what the righteousness tell you to do.
All right. That's right.
So faith always is going to have action with it. Yes. And if faith don't have no action, it's dead.
Yes.
Yes. Now look, let's go to Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Josh, give me the Amplified Bible. Now here's how faith comes. If you don't learn this, you're in trouble. You're going to miss what I preach. Faith cometh by hearing. And hearing the word of God. How many of y'all know that?
Amen.
But have you ever found out what the word of God is? Have you ever found out what the word of God is? The word of God is the words that came from Jesus' lips, the Messiah. And I just believe, man, we're going to have to go back to the teachings of Jesus. I just don't, the whole church started with only but the teachings. They didn't start with the letters. They had no letters. All they had was Jesus said, whatsoever I command you, go teach. Now, how could the church get away from that today? When the church started with Jesus' teachings. And the epistles built on top of it. But the epistles, you can't build the epistles. They have to build on top of Jesus' teachings. Jesus' words. Why? Well, Jesus taught us. Listen carefully to this. Faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. By the words that came from Jesus' lips, the Messiah. So anytime you need faith, you didn't need to go hear something from Jesus. And faith automatically come to you. Why? Because Jesus is faith. So faith cometh by hearing. And hearing the words or the message that came from Jesus' lips, the Messiah. And so you get people with problems all the time. And they don't even understand. They need faith. They need a word from Jesus. Why? Because he is faithful that promise. And you have to be taught that Jesus can't lie.
Amen.
Now, let me show you what's going to work for you every day. Now, I used to be on crack and cocaine and heroin. I used to rob banks and grocery stores and restaurants. And I was a gambler, a hustler. I was just real mean. Just a bona fide sinner. I smoked cigarettes for 12 years, reefer. I drank beer and Hennessy, Kvase, and gin, vodka, anything, you know, when you didn't have nothing. I mean, how many of y'all remember them days the Lord delivered you from a... Okay, that's good. And the rest of y'all were sinners too, so, you know, you just didn't fall maybe in one of them categories, but it's some lying and stealing and lusting and some stuff we could go and hook you up in. Amen, because the Bible says everybody done sin and come short of the glory of God. Now, we don't have to keep sinning. Not in Jesus. And so the Lord set me free June 30th, 1988 at 10:35 p.m. in the Samaria Drug Treatment Center on Sham Avenue off North 6th, across from Tennessee Titans Stadium. I went by there a few months ago and looked at the room I was in when that bright light came in there, and Jesus changed me when I gave my life to him to serve him and follow him and to do God's will. This was in June 30th, 1988, and here it is now, 2012, and I hadn't been back. I just ain't been back. I ain't been back to lust for women. I had, in 23 and a half years, by the grace of God, by Jesus' faith working in me, I haven't looked at one woman and won't go to bed with her. It just ain't happened. Now, did I get thoughts? Did I get tempted? Oh, absolutely. Had to repent for some thoughts. But not in my heart did I want to sin against God. It just ain't been there. And then in 23 and a half years, I've never practiced sin. I just ain't done it. I've never told Jesus I ain't going to do what he say, or ignored him, or just brushed him off like he didn't mean nothing to me. Now, I've never done that one time in my Christian walk. And so, you know, it's not about Jesus ain't called me to be perfect. He's called me to believe in him who he is.
Right.
So that what's not perfected in me, he can perfect. And so if you're looking at you, if you keep any kind of eye on you, you're going to fail. If you see you any kind of way, you're going to fail. If you remember anything about you and discuss about you, you're going to fail. Only Jesus can bring you success.
Amen.
And then he got to teach you not only success, but how did he do it? So let's look now how Jesus done it. Let's go to John chapter 8, verse 27. And John chapter 8, verse 27. They understood not that he spake to them of the Father. Then said Jesus unto them, when you have lifted up the Son of Man, then shall you know that I am he. Now let me help you all. We need to find out when we're lifted up in a problem. That's when you find out who you are. Jesus said, when y'all lift me up, and that's when y'all don't know that I'm he. So never exalt yourself. Always wait till tests come and storms so they can tell you where you at. Because they're going to tell you where you at. They're going to tell you where your faith is. They're going to tell you where your trust is. They're going to tell you where you at. You're going to cry and whine, or you're going to shout and rejoice, but you're going to do something in them tests. That's the truth. Then said Jesus unto them, When you have lifted up the Son of Man, then shall you know that I am he. Now let me tell y'all something about holding fast to the confession of faith of Jesus, who he is and what he did. Now, first of all, most people don't even know who Jesus is, biblically. Lamb of God, Son of God, and all them are titles. They won't work in no test. His titles won't work. You got to know who he is. Now, who is Jesus? You ready? Get in your mind so you can be wrong or right. You ready? Mm-hmm. He's the one that's sent from God with no sin. And that's who he is. Amen. Amen. Now, man, if you don't get a hold of that, you're going to keep struggles in your life. If you don't get in your mouth, Jesus is the one sent from God with no sin. And then you got to know, what did Jesus do? What did Jesus do? Now don't say he died, because he did die. But what did he do? He, in dying, he took your sins away. See, it's got to be something great about you. Because the problems I'm going to deal with in this world has to do with sin. And so when you believe that he took your sins away, you'll never live in condemnation no more the rest of your life. Because you can go to Jesus and confess your sin, that he is faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. And so you got to know he done took them away. So that when you go to him, you're not going to him to get him to forgive you. You're going to him to receive what he's already done for you. Because he's provided forgiveness. Even though he's provided forgiveness, don't mean you've accepted it and walking in it again. Like some people preach on TV today. That you already forgiven, and it don't matter, it do matter. And they said 1 John chapter 1 was wrote to sinners. Sinners. Jesus told me in 88, after I sinned for the first time, after 3 months, I just walked into glory for 3 months. I never did repent, never did do nothing wrong. And I finally didn't tell them people the truth about a license plate. And I was afraid. And the devil said, that's it. And Jesus, I hadn't got to 1 John chapter 1 yet. I hadn't read that before. I didn't know that the Lord would forgive you. And so because I didn't have a light, the devil came to condemn me. And Jesus finally just opened my Bible up 3 days later and took all the words off the page, said verse 9. And I read, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And then Jesus spoke to me and said, the first time you asked me, I forgave you and forgot it. I said, what? Well, who was that? He said, that was your enemy. And so that was revelation to me. Now most Christians don't have that revelation. Because they ask him again. They ask him again to forgive them of the same thing. Because they don't feel like they're forgiven. Because it just feels horrible. But you can't live by feelings. You got to live by Jesus. It's faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you. It's not a feeling. Faith is not a feeling. It's what Jesus, it's who Jesus is. Come on. And what Jesus did. Who is he? He's the one sent from God with no sin. That means ain't no mess up in him. That means anything you messed up in, he can fix. He can turn it around. And then he took your sins away. Most believers don't even talk this every day. They don't even talk every day who Jesus is and what Jesus did. They don't talk every day, he took all my sins away. They don't talk this every day. But let me tell you why you need to talk this. This is your hope. The Bible said in Ephesians 2 verse 12 that at that time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers to the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in this world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were afar off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. How could we not talk this every day? How could we not voice this? This is our faith. Your faith has to hear it. Your faith has to believe it. Your faith has to speak it, and then your faith got to do what he tell you to do. Or it ain't faith. And so when you find people, Pastor Gills, I struggle with this. I say, well, you say you do. So I got to get you to believe in Jesus. So you quit struggling with that. I see, Jesus told me, after he delivered me, he said, now I want you to go tell him how I loved you. So I began to go give testimonies. Jesus set me free from drugs. Jesus set me free from crack. Jesus set me free from lust. Jesus set me free from gambling. Jesus set me free from hustling. Jesus set me free from worry, stress, and depression. And you know the thing that amazed me the most about Jesus? This amazed me that when you're in NA and AA and they give you a 30-day chip, in 30 days I got up, they let you get up and share after you get your chip. And I said, you know the most of, by the grace of God and Jesus Christ, I'm here clean and sober. And I'm just here to let all y'all know I won't never use no more the rest of my life. Oh, no. They didn't understand faith in Jesus, that Jesus had the power to keep me from going back. And what I was saying to them was why I wasn't going back. And I went and told him, I said, you all, the most amazing thing to me, and they want you to tell you about your 30 days. I said, I hadn't been depressed or worried in 30 days. And then they gave you 60 days. I said, in 60 days, y'all, I hadn't been worried or depressed. And then night, I got a 90-day chip, and I said it again. And then a 6-month chip, and I said it again. And then a year chip, and I got a 9-month chip. And then I got a year chip. I said, y'all, it's been a whole year. And in a whole year, I ain't been depressed or worried. And then I got my 2-year chip. Wallella. And I told him in 2 years, I said, in 2 years, I ain't been depressed or worried. I'm talking about a whole day. It came now. Don't think it didn't come. It never stayed. Because Jesus taught me how to witness. He taught me how to stay in the anointing. He taught me, listen, he taught me that the devil can't handle when you give this away. Anytime you're struggling, you need to go love somebody. Because when Jesus died on the cross, he was dying to love us. And he rose with all power in heaven and earth. Anytime you die to love somebody else, power shows up for you. So while I was praying for somebody else to get free, the freedom came on me. And the anointing destroyed the yoke off of me. And so a lot of people go through problems. All they do is talk about problems. But they need to go find somebody to talk to about Jesus. Because while you telling them what he can do for them, you hearing yourself what he can do for you. Oh, y'all. And so people just live in struggle. And then I got my 5 year. I left, but I came back 7 years and I said, y'all, it's been 7 years. By the grace of God, Jesus Christ, I'm here clean soul. And I'm here to tell y'all I never will use no more. Haven't in 7 years. Hadn't been back once. And I haven't been depressed a word in 7 years. And y'all know I came here in the early 90s. Listen, when I get up and give my testimony, the first thing I tell y'all, I ain't been depressed. Since June 30, 1990, hadn't had a stressful day. And then now I'm back now. It's been 20 years, and I still got the same testimony.
Amen.
Still to maintain that same testimony. Haven't been laid on nothing. And I'm totally debt free. It took me 7 years to pay my house off, to believe the Lord to pay it off. I tried to change it and cut it to 3. He didn't let me because I done prayed and believed. And in 7 years or less, I'd have to pay it off. And that's exactly the 7th year was exactly when the Lord brought all the money in to pay it off.
Praise God.
Church debt free. Everything debt free. Why? I just learned how to hear what he say and believe and speak it. And then do what he tell me. Walk in love toward everybody.
Amen.
One thing I'm going to do, I don't care what nobody... I know I'm going to live long because I know how I live in love every day. Man, you watch people don't walk in love. They're going to have some trouble. So here, they're going to stay in John 8 now. I want you to see something. I ain't even talked to Revelation yet. Jesus, now let me tell you something. It's the key for the confession of your faith. Who Jesus is. Now, who is Jesus? The one sent from God with what? No sin. And then what did he do? He took our sins away. See, you don't know it yet. You ain't never been taught this. Some of y'all have. But you ain't never been taught this. So you don't know it. This is your success. Learn it. Study it. Speak it. Get it in your spirit. Who is Jesus? He's the one sent from God with no sin. When you become, do you know what that means? The one sent from God with no sin. Do you know this? Say, I don't know, Pastor Gale. This ain't knowledge you don't know so you can learn. Because you ain't never learn and you think you know. Just be ignorant and dumb like I've been for years. That's the only people the Lord teach. He don't never teach intellectuals and smart people. He don't show them nothing in the Bible. He only teaches babes, infants. You cannot enter this kingdom of heaven unless you come as a little child. So what does it mean Jesus is the one sent from God with no sin? No sin. It means he knows everything. He's got everything figured out. He knows exactly how to work out anything you're going through. Before you go through it, he already know how to work it out. The Bible said Jesus overcame the world. He defeated all the works of the devil. He has given us authority to tread upon the serpents and demons and evil spirits and over all. Said in Luke 10:19, nothing shall by any means hurt thee. Listen, you got to be an awesome person to tell everybody that nothing shall by any means hurt you. And you give everybody the thought, now you mighty. Now you mighty. To tell everybody, whatever you ask in my name, I will do. Now you just making that statement out there for everybody. Gotta be mighty. It's the one sent from God with no sin. What does that mean? He knows everything and got everything what? Figured out. So you can't face nothing that Jesus ain't got worked out. Now have faith in him. Now how do you have faith in him? You got to hear what I just said and say it. And then do what he tell you. Y'all, you can't come to church and be a student. You got to come to be an adherent to the teachings of Jesus and conduct your life in the way he told you to do. You got to get this stuff on your lips. Now, here's the most important thing to make your faith work, to make Jesus work in your life. You got to see. Listen, how did Jesus live perfect? Well, he was. That's who he was. But now I ask you another question. How did Jesus live perfect? What was the key to his faith in God? Because we know he had faith in God. And he never got out of faith. He never got out of love. And that's the only time you can get in sin is when you're out of love. You're out of who God is in Jesus. That's when you sin, when you're out of that. When you're in that, you don't. So what was the key? All right, let's read it, verse 28. No, I want you to get this. And then Jesus said, when you have lifted up Son of Man, then shall you know that I am he. Now here it is right here. Get this. And I do nothing of myself. See, people think they're smart with the Bible. They're really dumb and ignorant. See, people ain't lucky in pride. And you can't teach them. Because they come to church thinking they know this stuff. They really don't know nothing. They broke, they're struggling. They don't know how to get the Lord to work in every area. See, when you get a hold of truth, you can get it to work for you in every area. And so why I'm saying that is so people can get humble. And look, the thing you got to be the most sure about, you need to be solid on this one. You need to be 1,000% sure that you can do nothing of yourself. You need to be totally convinced out of your mind, wacky, that you can do nothing of yourself. Faith will never work when you got anything to do with this. And faith will work when Jesus got all to do with it. Because he's faith. So Jesus said, I can do nothing of myself. Now watch that. Watch the key to his success. Because, nobody lived perfect but him. So, he's the only one we can look at. Because I got to tell you, I failed and repented, and he showed me what to do. But when we look at him, we don't see nothing wrong. Look now. And that I do nothing of myself, but as my Father have taught me. Now watch the key. What's the key? Don't read. Look at your Bible. What's the key? What's the key? As the Father taught me. Not. As the Father taught me. That's right. But what's the next thing? I speak. Look, he didn't say now my mom and daddy and all them, you understand? They're going to speak some over us too. But he said, if you're going to live this, there's something you're going to have to speak. And what are you going to speak? What Jesus done taught you. And Jesus said, I do nothing of myself, but as my Father have taught me, I speak these things. Look how his faith is working. Look how his faith is working. I speak these things. What's the key? First, he had to know that he could do nothing of himself. You're talking about Jesus. Jesus? You know, because a lot of y'all think that Jesus just came down here and could just do anything he wanted to. That's not true. If he could, we would have no example to trust and walk by faith. Turn them phones off. And walk by faith. We wouldn't have nobody to have an example how to trust, how to live in faith with, so we would know how to tap into Jesus, how he tapped into God as a man. We got to learn how to tap into Jesus the same way that Jesus tapped into the Father. He gives us the instructions here. First, he understood he could do nothing of himself. Listen, soon as you get in a test and trial, that's the first thing you all say, Lord, I don't know what to do. Then he needs to teach you something. See, you need to go read something he taught so you can hear something from him. And then you need to speak. And then look what he said in verse 29. And the Father's not left me alone. He's with me. You got to always, with your faith, know the Lord is with you. You can't never be in faith in Jesus and don't know the Lord is with you. Now, how do you always know the Lord is with you? How do you always know the Lord is with you? You got to have a word. What he said. And in Hebrew 13 verse 5 and 6, he said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So you can boldly say, the Lord is my helper. And you can't boldly say the Lord is your helper when you ain't boldly saying he'll never leave me nor forsake me. This is so you can boldly say the Lord's my helper. No, I ain't going under this. I done told the devil in tests and trials when it came my life, financial needs and things, I said, oh, you ain't going to work. You ain't going to work. You ain't going to last. That's all I tell him. See, what was I doing? I was believing in Jesus. Yes. It didn't work against him, and I'm trusting him. He's going to come through and show me what to do. I just said to him, oh, you ain't going to work. You ain't going to prosper. And go on back to sleep. And too many people miss sleep worrying about stuff. Because that thing's on your plate. It ain't on Jesus' plate. And so you're not speaking to where he can have it. And that how great he is. How much he conquered. What he overcame. Not you and me. And so if we don't see that we can do nothing of ourselves, and when people are in pride, they don't like to say that. People just do not, they do not want to admit they can't handle this. People try to handle stuff. Yeah. And Jesus said, the Father's not left me. Look what he said. And look what's coming out of his mouth. He said, and that he that sent me is with me. The Father have not left me alone, for I do always those things that please him. I wonder how many of y'all say that every day. Well, Pastor K, you know, we all sinners. And no, I ain't no sinner. No, Jesus don't make sinners. And you can't even follow Jesus and be a sinner. Because he can't conform no sinner to his image. He has to make you a new creature and born of his spirit. And then that's the man supposed to be following Jesus. And so he said, I always do those things that please him. Y'all, I'm going to tell y'all, I've been saying this for 23 and a half years. I've been telling people this in messages and personal, and everywhere I go, I do everything Jesus tells me to do. That's why I do. Some of y'all ain't never said that. Scared to say it. Because you want to focus on how you done missed it. You want to focus on your shortcomings. Lord, if I focus on them, I could never believe that. See, my always doing what he's saying is I always repent it and I always let him show me what to do. That's obedience. But doing everything right is not obedience to the Lord. It's letting him get it right in your life. Now, when Jesus got through saying this, I always do those things that please him. God is with me. Now look at verse 30. And as he spake these words, what happened? Oh, some believing came on him. How in the world you think you're going to believe on him? You ain't got no word. He ain't said nothing to you. Well, what did the Lord say? Oh, I'm standing on the word. I said, well, what word? Oh, I'm just standing on the word. Well, what word? Which one? And people live every day and not even have one word from Jesus. And most preachers don't even preach Jesus' words. They preach something about the Bible, but ain't nothing about Jesus. And without Jesus, you can't have faith. You got something. And Jesus said, as he spake these words, many believed on him. Now, how you done believe on him? What do you stand on every day to live perfect, mature? What do you stand on every day to know you're going to win, to know you're going to overcome? Well, I stand on, I'm more than a conqueror through Jesus who loved me. I can do anything through Christ who always infuses me with inner strength. I know he redeems my life from destruction. He crowns me with loving kindness and tender mercies. He satisfies my mouth with good things. My youth is always renewed like the eagles. I've never missed church in 23 and a half years. I've never missed a preaching engagement.